dark meat. That's also where the animals will come in from outside. They'll walk around, sit around, eat bugs, drink water, go to sleep, go right back out. Natural instincts don't let them go into the dark zone. They can't see to get out. So this is as far as they'll come in. Now this is a solution cave, meaning it was formed by water, and it is still being formed by water. It's a limestone cave, and limestone's very porous. So that's why you hear water drops, you'll see stalactites. Now, way back when, the cave came empty from the water going out. Nothing was in here. No formations whatsoever. It started growing. These were the very first things that grew in the cave. These little things called soda straws, right here, hanging down. Little bitty things. They're just like a straw you drink out of at home, only they're made out of stone. Now, when they get so big after a while, as they're starting to on this front row here, they'll start making stalactites. The water no longer will come from the inside, it'll come from the outside. And that's when you have your stalactites like you have right here at the back. They eventually form some stalagmites from the minerals being dropped down. Okay, now, back in the 30s during the Depression, the owner of the cave, he was trying to get his family through the Depression. Bad times for everybody back then. He came up with this wonderful idea. I've got a dark, damp, 60-degree high humidity cave. What can I grow in it? He come down here and put a garden in. So what do you think he started growing in here? Starts with an M. Mushrooms. This morning, a gentleman hollered out, marijuana. I had to explain to him why you couldn't grow marijuana in a cave. He didn't want to know how I knew so much about it. I don't. Okay, anyway, this is the very first garden he planted. He planted a little button mushroom spores, and it started coming up everywhere. I mean, they popped up everywhere, they say. Well, he thought, heck, if it's going on here, I got a whole cave. He started planting huge gardens out through here. He grew so many mushrooms. He was taking them up to the Springfield market. He was trading and selling them. He got his family through the Depression. Yeah, he did real well. It's called using the resources that you have at hand, right? Who would have thought of something like that? I sure probably wouldn't have, but he did good. Okay, we're going to go on up here now and to another stop, and we're going to talk some more about stuff, okay? Any questions so far?
Nope.
No? Okay, well, we're going to head on up. Who wants to run way back in the back and turn the light switch on for me? Yeah, see, you would.